The civil society groups have demanded a high-level probe into the killing of 15 civilians by Indian troops in Indian-disturbed state of Nagaland. The gruesome incident took place between Oting and Tiru villages of the Mon district of Nagaland when some daily wage laborers were returning home in a pickup van from a coal mine in the evening of Sunday, December 4th. Nagaland Commissioner Rovilatu Moore and Director General of Police T. John Long Kumar have confirmed that Indian Army had tried to hide six dead bodies of civilians by raping and loading them in another truck and covering them with tarpaulin. Meanwhile, the people from Mon district staged strong protest demonstration against the killings and burnt structures. Locals attacked an Indian Army camp in the district and destroyed it. Nagaland Chief Minister T.R. Zilang's house was also burned down by the violent agitators in the state capital of Kohima. Naga people held funeral rites for killed civilians amid intense security and sporadic internet outages aimed at dumping fresh unrest in the strife-torn region. Students Islamic Organization of India, SIO, called the killing of civilians in Nagaland a new low in the brutality of Indian armed forces. Jan Hastakshep, a people's intervention group, in a statement while condemning the killing, said criminal misconduct of Indian Army, paramilitary and police, be it in Northeast Kashmir or even in Uttar Pradesh, is bound to lend little credibility to the claims of botched encounter in the eyes of the people in Nagaland or the vast masses. Indian Bollywood actress Sabara Bhaskar, a staunch critic of Hindu Fascist Brigade, reacted sharply to the fresh incident of massacre of innocent Nagas, has called for the repeal of two black laws, Armed Forces Special Powers Act and Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. Situation in Madhya Pradesh is tense after Hindu extremists associated with Bajrang Dal attacked a Christian missionary school in Ganj Basora town of Vidisha district. The attack took place when the students of class 12 were sitting for a mathematics exam. Meanwhile, in Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir, dozens of youth have been arrested during raids on their houses by Indian forces in almost all districts of the Kashmir Valley and some Muslim majority areas of Jammu region. The troops forced the inmates, including women, children and elderly, to stay outdoors in shivering cold during the operations in Srinagar, Baramulla, Bandipora, Badgam, Kupwara, Pulwama, Shopian, Islamabad, Kulgam, Rajouri and Poonch districts. The troops subjected the residents to harassment and intimidation. Many journalists complained that forces personnel threatened them with dire consequences if they filed any story on the brutal raids and arrests. The All Parties Hurriyat Conference and other Hurriyat leaders and organizations, in their statements issued in Srinagar, strongly condemned the Indian brutalities against Kashmiri people. The APHC urged the international community to take notice of the ongoing Indian state terrorism in occupied territory. Hurriyat leaders Khwaja Firdaus and Devinder Singh Behl said that India had failed to suppress the Kashmiri struggle for freedom despite using all inhuman tactics, including torture, arrests, and massacres in the territory. Meanwhile, pro-freedom posters appeared in Azmat Abad and adjoining areas of Thanamandi in Rajouri district. The posters called for an end to India's illegal occupation of Jammu and Kashmir. Indian police have registered a case against unknown men under Black Law, Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. The United Peace Alliance, an umbrella body of Jammu-based resistance organizations, at a meeting strongly condemned the Delhi-based JC publication for committing highly blasphemous act in the 7th Standard Book. The alliance chairman, Mir Shahid Saleem, called it a deliberate attempt to hurt the sentiments of the Muslims. Sikh leader Harsis Singh Kranti said the act could only be possible when some sections in the corridors of power are backing the evil elements.